Can you see? My bowls were delivered. Welcome to Friday's episode of Keto Chronicles, Progress Plateaus and Palate Pleasers. Before I start, I want to introduce a brand new title to my Monday recipes that I'm just now starting. Monday Munchies, Keto Edition. So be sure to stay tuned on Mondays for fantastic recipes, which, by the way, it's going to be a toss-up. Either this keto chicken cordon bleu meatball or these pork chops with some sort of good sauce on there. I don't know. Now that I think of it, I'll probably put a poll in the community tab and see which one y'all would decide. Or you can comment below. Also, I've recently discovered that I really need a goal. I've just kind of been saying, well, how much weight am I going to lose in a month? And then I'm there and I'm like, well, I didn't really have a goal. And so I've been kind of teetering on that. Well, no, I flat out went over the cliff on Tuesday. I have hair on my lip gloss. Anyway, I'll get to what I was eating this week in a minute. My goal is going to be to hit 175. That's probably going to be in a month, but I am really going to put the brakes on everything. I'll tell you what, I'm probably only going to be eating chicken. I had to pause the video because my Alexa, she's listening. She scares me. She's like my mom, but she reminds me to take my vitamins every day. So I let her be in the house. Anyway, goal weight, 175. By the way, I haven't been able to wear this ring in forever. Not even 2 weeks ago. Did you see my balls? I got my balls. Also, so if you're new here, I did a 1 week of not spending any money. I was really good. I only spent like 99 cents and then I think $2.99 and that was it. I was really going to go hard and buy some stuff off of Amazon, but I didn't. But yesterday I was really wanting to buy a couple more shirts because I don't have a whole lot that fit me anymore since I've lost a lot of weight. So I went into my closet and I don't ever go into my closet ever. I just have clothes and drawers. And I found so much stuff that I was like, I bet I can fit into. One of them is this shirt. And look, like it's loose on me. Anyway, so I didn't need to buy anything from Amazon. But what was super cute was I was just putting everything on top of the bathroom countertop. And I went to go do something. Whenever I came back, it was the most adorable thing. My little cat, Lily, must have been investigating and all the clothes fell because I remember coming back and seeing them on the floor and she was nowhere to be seen, which means it scared her and she hid. And for some reason, I left the clothes there because I was like, I was too tired or something. Point is, I go back in there and she is sleeping on the things. I was like, oh, this is so cute. So I still haven't even tried them on. So I'm waiting until later on, you know, because now that I have all my makeup all done and all that, you know. Anyway, another thing, get on with your way in, Bonnie. I decided to go ahead and book a cruise. I started doing cruises like a long time ago. Then I got my parents involved. Then occasionally my sister and her family would go with us. Anyway, the last time it was kind of a mess. I was super sick. It's a long story about cruising, but I ended up putting a deposit down for my parents and myself in a nice, fabulous owner suite. I'm probably going to put a picture up of it if I can remember. We did this cruise on Royal Caribbean Liberty of the Seas, and I'll tell you what, it was the most fun I had. And with my parents, it was just fun times. And I recorded it. Now, I didn't do keto on the cruise, but I do have a playlist of all of that Liberty of the Seas cruise that I went on. And it was so much fun. We're going to be doing it again on Voyager of the Seas. Anyway, it's going to be fun. So expect videos late January, early February of my keto low carb cruise. All right, weigh in time. You probably fast forwarded anyway. Last Friday, I weighed in and it was 179 even. Saturday, I went to the parents' house and we had Mexican food delivered. Oh, my favorite. I ended up looking through their chicken dinners and there was one that was bacon wrapped chicken with some sort of cheese on the inside. I got that and it was fantastic. Sunday was fun. Have y'all ever heard of fondue? You've probably heard of cheese fondue, chocolate fondue, but this is meat fondue. I knew we were going to be doing fondue later, so I was looking through the fridge, seeing what they had there. And really the only thing they had was bologna, but I was starving. So I had two pieces of bologna with cheddar cheese, and that was enough for me. Got me through it until we had fondue. Okay, so look at this. First of all, my brother-in-law makes this cucumber tomato salad, and it's so good. I'm going to be doing that later on this salad. Anyway, if you see these dips in front of the plates, those are different types of sour cream based dips that my mom does. One of them is a dill. Another one has chili sauce in it. And then the other one is like a mustard sour cream. So what you do is you skewer the meat with your little skewer and you put it into the oil and then it will cook. And in about like 2 minutes or so, you just pull it out. If you see me pulling out, I don't know how far the video is, but if you see me pulling out the one that was for my dad, it's so good. And you just continuously rotate. I'm telling you what, it's so fantastic. It's pretty much keto, but they do use peanut oil. Whenever I was looking it up, it was kind of tantamount to soybean oil where it's pro-inflammatory, but I wasn't going to request just a plain old avocado oil one. And that stuff is expensive. We're not doing that. Monday, I had made those pizza rolls. If you haven't seen the video, it's ridiculously easy. Go make them. It's so good. I'll put the card up. Tuesday is where I had the oopsie. It wasn't even an oopsie. It was just a boom right off the cliff. I wasn't even going to cheat. I knew I was going to be super busy. So I was just like, you know, I'm going to order from a Mexican restaurant and I was just going to get these fantastic chicken fajita nachos. No refried beans. And I was just going to remove the chicken and cheese from the chips because my thought process was, if I tell them no chips, they're going to put less of the chicken fajita meat in there because it's just going to be these cubed chicken fajita meats and cheese. So I was thinking in order to keep the quantity high of the amount of chicken, I just said, do chicken, cheese, and chips. That was a mistake. I scraped off about three of those chips, gave the chips to the dog. And then I was like, well, okay, I'm going to try one. Ate the whole rest of them. Needless to say, that was a total bust. Well, how do you like that? My microphone stopped working and I just kept going. So Tuesday, boo. The problem was Wednesday, I really started to crave more carbs. And I'll be honest with you, it was like 9 a.m. And if it had been 10:30, I would have ordered Little Caesar's pizza because that's my nemesis. I ended up telling myself that I would find a Little Caesar's sauce recipe. And sure enough, I did. I went right to the store, came back, made myself that Little Caesar's pizza, and it was fantastic. That thing was so good. I had it 2 days in a row. And that's all I had was just the full pizza both days. This brings us to today where I weighed myself and it's 178.6. So almost a half a pound lost. Pretty darn good considering I had quite a bit of a cheat. Don't stop the video now because I have a Taco Bell hack coming up. So listen, you already know I had booked the cruise for my parents and myself and put a deposit down. It was a fairly big deposit. 2 days later, I get two letters in the mail that are big medical bills. I was so mad. And I do know that I have a doctor's appointment coming up. And so I had to go get blood work from the vampires today. I had my dad pick me up because the parking there is horrendous. I go strolling in there to get my blood work done. She's like, that'll be $296. Here I go again. I was so close to paying off all of my medical expenses. Needless to say, I was upset, pissed off. So on the way back, I already knew that Taco Bell had brought back the volcano menu. So I get home and now I have Taco Bell on my mind. Well, I'm looking through and I only see that it's a taco and a burrito on there. So I'm like, oh, well, forget it. And at my mind at this point, I had already said, I've set a goal of 175. Today is the only day I'll be able to do anything. So I'm just going to do it. I kind of had to back it up because the more that I do something, it's just going to make it more difficult for me to end up where I want to be. So I was like, okay, what can I do to compromise? So sure enough, I got some chicken chipotle melts because it's only chicken, cheese, and sauce. Also, really quick note, I had just gotten back from the vampires. So just note, I'll have a cotton ball thingy here. All right, guys, I know I've already explained everything. Three chicken chipotle melts is what I got from Taco Bell. We don't need those tortillas. I'm dying, but I'm gonna do this right, unlike what I did the other day. Egg life wraps. And if you don't know, egg life wraps are really good. Now this is pretty much dirty keto because there's soybean oil in here. Okay, here's something else that I will admit. I did have a volcano taco. Was it worth it? Yes. Don't stop the video because I have one more hack. I forgot that I had also ordered, and I forget what it's called, so I'll put a picture of it here. And it has grilled chicken, lettuce, tomato, avocado ranch, and chipotle sauce. It comes with tortilla strips, but I said no to those. No to the tortilla strips, but I ate a taco. Anyway, I just put that stuff inside, and I'll tell you what, it was a perfect amount for the wrap. Honestly, This was 10,000 times better than completely ordering whatever I wanted to at Taco Bell. So I'm very proud of myself. And so that was a win for me. We have our Mondays and Fridays all figured out. Monday Munchies with recipes and Friday Keto Chronicles with weigh-ins, what I eat in a day, and everything in between. I'll also occasionally be throwing in a peek of the week. If you're new here and you want to catch up on all the drama, click here. It'll also explain about my bulge. If you want to make sure not to miss an update, click the subscribe button and hit that bell. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. I'll see you guys next time.